Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will learn about the difference between the chlorine demand and the residual chlorine. Let's start by the chlorine demand. As a general rule, when we add chlorine in the water, it will react with any organic and inorganic material. So, let's say I have a tank full of water and we are adding chlorine and we have some contaminants. So when we add the chlorine will react with these contaminants and the amount of chlorine will decrease because it reacted with these contaminants. So the consumed chlorine is referred to as the chlorine demand. As chlorine is consumed during these reactions, the concentration of chlorine decreases. So the chlorine demand is the amount of consumed chlorine when added to the water. Now note that a highly polluted water will require more chlorine. So we will have a higher chlorine demand compared to a clean water. Now what is the residual chlorine dose? Residual chlorine is actually very important to keep the water disinfected, and this is a very important feature of the chlorine. So when we added the chlorine and when the chlorine reacted with the contaminants, we said that this is chlorine demand. After a while, we will still have a certain amount of chlorine, and this chlorine is known as the residual chlorine. So this residual chlorine will actually disinfect any recontamination and it will protect the water from any recontamination from contaminants. It will prevent bacterial growth in the treated water. And the desirable free chlorine level is 0.2 to 0.5 milligrams per liter. So this will require the addition of 1 to 5 milligrams of chlorine. So initially we have to add between 1 to 5 milligrams per liter of chlorine. Here we are talking about drinking water. So we have to add about 1 to 5 milligrams per liter of chlorine. Some will be consumed as chlorine demand dose, and the amount of chlorine that will stay in the water is known as residual chlorine. Now, at more than 0.3 milligrams per liter, this will cause a distinctive taste and odor, so we will feel the presence of the chlorine. So we have to stay at a level less than 0.3 milligrams per liter. Now, ideally, the right dose must be determined through trial and error. We have to test, to keep testing the amount of needed chlorine in the water to be treated until we reach the required residual chlorine dose.